This Sunday, April 5th, is the beginning of Holy Week. We celebrate it as Palm Sunday or Passion Sunday. We celebrate not only the triumphant entry of Jesus into Jerusalem, but we also know that at the end of that week, that he will be put to death, death on a cross. As you begin to think about Holy Week and what you're going to pray about and think about, I want to hold these persons up for your prayers and your thoughts. First, the medical personnel in all of our communities that are dealing with persons and seeking to bring compassion, care to those who are suffering from the coronavirus. I'm grateful especially for physicians and nurses and other medical personnel in hospitals and clinics who are on the front line and sacrificing their own health and perhaps even their own lives. I find them to be heroes for me, and I think about them each and every day. In fact, I don't think about them just once, but several times. But during Holy Week, in which we begin with, again, that celebration of Jesus entering into Jerusalem, I want you to think about people who are being faithful. They might not claim a faith, but they're being faithful to what we know is the greater cause of humanity, and that is to really see themselves as living in a community in which they care for all. And that certainly is a value that we hold as Christians. So as we move through Holy Week, and you will receive a devotional and an email each and every day from one of our cabinet members, I want you to read the devotional and read the scripture passage that goes with it and ask yourself some questions about how you can become an even more faithful follower of Jesus. I do hope that this is a most meaningful time for you. And I know that we'll not spend it in public worship together in local churches, but we'll worship online. We'll worship silently among our families. But let this be an authentic time for you, your families, the people you love, your friends, as they seek to walk more deeply with our God in Christ. May you have a blessed week.